Hi, and welcome to our video of the Roman baths in Bath. Bath can be found in the county of Somerset in the southwest of the UK, and the city is recognised by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site. And now we're going to take a look at one of Bath's must-see attractions, the Roman baths. Located in the centre of the city, right next to Bath's beautiful Abbey. So without further ado, let's make our way down to Abbey Churchyard and the entrance to the Roman Baths. I'll drop a link in the description to their site where you can find opening times, pricing, and also pre-book your tickets. Once you step inside, take a moment to enjoy the late Victorian building the ticket office is located in. However, we've come to look at the Roman Baths, right? Now a bit of a spoiler alert. We're standing on a Victorian terrace built in the 1890s. The statues to Roman emperors and governors of Britain, 1894. The columns supporting the terrace, well, you get the picture. But nobody's trying to deceive you. It's just that the Roman baths were rediscovered in the late Victorian period, and they understood the importance of this historical site that gave Bath its name. Okay, the Romans called Bath Aqua Sulis, or Water of Sulis, after the goddess Sulis, who the Romans blended with their goddess Minerva to give us Sulis Mineva. After the Romans left Britannia in around 400 AD, the Roman baths started to fall into disrepair, and over the centuries it was lost as Bath grew up around it. It was the Victorians who rediscovered it and started the work that makes the Roman baths the attraction it is today. Although the team behind it now brought it bang up to date with an audio guide included in the price to give you as much detail as you want, there's also additional commentary on specific exhibits by the author Bill Bryson. The baths were founded on a natural geothermal hot spring by the Romans in around AD 60 to 70, not that long after the Roman invasion of AD 43. The complex continued to grow until after the Romans left some 300 or so years later. As I mentioned, the whole site was lost and the baths complex was discovered below the modern street level. Bath, the city, had grown up around it, including the impressive Bath Abbey. It seems the Victorians had seamlessly blended the discovery into the city's fabric to give you a new reason to visit Bath. It seems strange when you think of Bath. You think of the Romans and the Georgians, but not the other periods of British history. I think we need to thank the Victorians for their rediscovery. As we head inside, we get a first glimpse of the hot springs that made this all possible at the base of the Victorian pump room. And from inside the Roman Bath Museum, we get to see the Great Bath from another perspective. It's here you get a glimpse of how it would have looked, and the biggest surprise is that the Great Bath would have been covered under a curved roof. I suppose it makes sense. This is England after all. The next surprise is the Roman temple with its temple pediment. Sections remain and the story of how it would have looked brought to life with a projection overlaid on the stonework. You then wander through the temple courtyard. This visit to the Roman Bath is giving you a greater insight into Roman life. I have to be honest, I hadn't expected this. Again, the commentary gives you additional information on the history of Roman Britain. You then come face to face with a rare gilt bronze head of the goddess Sulis Mineva. The sculpture is believed to date from the 1st century AD. So how long will it take to explore the Roman Baths? We were on a tight schedule, so we took around about 90 minutes, but you could spend a lot longer. Also, for the sake of clarity, we were visiting the Roman Baths on a media pass as guests of Visit Bath. But I hope you realise how much we genuinely enjoyed this experience, Roman drains and all. If you want to catch our other experiences in Bath, then please don't forget to subscribe. We now reappear at the lower level of the Great Bath, and I'll just tell you about the hot water that feeds the Roman baths. Rain falling on the Mendip Hills, around 17 miles southwest, filters through carniferous limestone to a depth of about 1.5 miles below the surface. Here it gets heated and percolates up through fractures in the Jurassic rock below the city. The water is heated to around 40 degrees centigrade or 105 degrees Fahrenheit, and over 1.25 million litres flow from the spring every day. That's just amazing. Our journey continues past the immersion pool through separate rooms of the Roman baths. Using multimedia displays to demonstrate how all walks of life would have interacted at these baths in the 1st to 4th century AD. I found this fascinating, and it left me wondering how much more of Roman Britain is hidden under our feet, ready to be discovered. We pass through the East Baths before returning to the Great Bath. It seems all paths lead back to here. Now a question for you. Have you visited the Roman Baths in Bath? If so, what did you think? Are you planning to visit Bath and other Roman Baths on your must-visit list? I'd love to know, so drop us a comment below. Anyway, let's just have a moment to reflect. We now arrive at what would have been the West Bath. It's where visitors now toss a coin for luck. You don't need to flip me a coin, just give me a like. I'll be happy with that. It's now time to draw this video to a close. I really hope you like what we put together and you're inspired to visit Bath and make the Roman Bath part of that trip. Thanks so much and happy travels.